Mesdames, Messieurs,
Gentlemen,
le président de la République,
the President of the Republic, the Prime Minister have said so strongly. We're fighting a war against terrorists, both at home and abroad. The investigation continues to establish the whole truth about these abject attacks which bloodied Paris on Friday evening. The investigation has progressed in close cooperation with our European partners. The public prosecutor has announced the latest developments. The threat of other terrorist acts remains high, and the Prime Minister reminded us of this again this morning. This threat is not new. It has been rumored and has called for total mobilization of our investigation and intelligence services. We have adapted our set of laws, we have strengthened our resources and reorganized our methods to fight a completely new form of terrorist risk. The Prime Minister reminded us, six attacks were foiled since the spring of this year. The legal framework that we have put in place with the laws of 2012 and 2014 have strengthened our instruments in the fight against terrorist threats, and 203 people have not been allowed to leave the country, 60 people have not been allowed to enter the country because their presence in France would have been a threat to our security. 87 locations have been put under administrative watch, and six people have been deprived of their French nationality. 34 people have been expelled, 34 foreigners have been expelled because of their links with the jihadist movement, and some imams who preach hatred and these expulsion orders have occurred this year. For several months, the Ministry of the Interior has brought together evidence that will lead to the banning of religious organizations which support violence. These procedures for banning these organizations are underway and they will be submitted to the Cabinet. The legal framework of the state of emergency since Friday has allowed us to boost our work, to accelerate preventive action for the purpose of protecting French citizens. I have asked for an extraordinary mobilization of our forces thanks to the state of emergency in terms of putting people under house arrest and of carrying out administrative searches. As regards house arrest, I have, over the last 48 hours, ordered 104 people to be put under house arrest. These people have been followed by our intelligence services very closely. Last night, across the whole of France, the police and the gendarmes, with the support of our intelligence services, both local and central, carried out 168 administrative searches of the homes of individuals who are considered as suspects for various reasons. Beyond seizing assets, beyond these arrests, these searches have enabled us to accelerate, and that's very important, to accelerate our investigations regarding the radicalized objectives and to provide us with more information. The state of emergency, therefore, shows how effective it is. These searches have taken place in 19 counties in the Paris area, in Lille in the north, Lyon, Toulouse, Marseille, across all the major metropolitan areas of France. No part of the Republic is being neglected in the maximum level of alert which the law enforcement and intelligence services are placed at the moment under my authority. For the information of my fellow citizens, I would like to give you the results. 23 individuals have been arrested and placed under custody. 31 weapons, 19 handguns, 4 heavy weapons have been seized. 18 stocks of drugs have been found. IT, equipment, computers, mobile phones have been seized and will be examined very closely. For example, in the Rhône county, where there is a lot of drug trafficking and weapons trafficking in support of radical Islamists, the searches have allowed us to discover a Kalashnikov, 3 automatic pistols, and special bulletproof jackets. Under the responsibility, the supervision of the public prosecutor, search was carried out in the home of the families of some suspects, where we found ammunition, munitions, and even a rocket launcher. So the Criminal Investigation Department is carrying out these, is continuing these investigations. As you know, there can be links between the gangster world and the world of terrorism. All the information collected last night will be useful for fighting against terrorists, but also against gangsterism. I want everybody to be fully aware of the fact that this is just the beginning. We're going to continue. The Republic's response will be on a large scale and will be total and complete. Anybody who attacks the Republic will fight back and will catch up and will treat those criminals and accomplices as well, and those who have aided and abetted them and indoctrinated them. Therefore, as the Prime Minister said this morning, we are mobilizing all our legal resources in order to expel radical imams who preach hatred and to put in under house arrest people who should be, and to carry out searches of those who have been reported as particularly suspect. Ladies and gentlemen, in the face of terrorist barbarity, they have declared war on us. There is only one way forward. It is the way forward adopted by the French citizens and which the government is applying inflexibly. Our implacable response, the Republic's implacable response against those who wish to destroy it, the terrorists will never destroy the Republic, because it is the Republic which will destroy them. Thank you for your attention.